Yo, California Dad Club. We are live. What's going on, everybody?
What up, YouTube?
What's up, YouTube? Hold on, let me see this.
What up?
What's up? Gotta add those. Is that too much of clapping?
No, we deserve it.
Woo! Whoa. Today we got a special guest with us. We got Mr. Garrett Wheeler in the house.
Ow. Aloha.
Aloha. Hawaiian. I got hula girls on my shirt, bro. I'm feeling Hawaiian.
My favorite tattoo yours is that one.
This one?
Mm-hmm.
My monkey?
Your monkey.
You like Hawaiian the monkey?
Yeah.
Why?
Dude, my dad wants the monkey.
His dad can't hit my arm, bro. I gotta use that.
Sometimes. Mm-hmm. Oh, it's your right arm, too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he might not want that for that's reasons.
It's big, bro. It's bigger than the rest.
I wonder why.
This one's bigger than the rest of my other arms.
I wonder why.
Just letting you know. But yeah, I don't like that tattoo as much. That was a pretty drunk decision, so I'm glad somebody likes it.
Damn.
Oh, this is a damn.
At least you didn't get a face tat.
Not yet.
I got a face monkey.
Face monkey.
How you been, bro?
I've been good. I've been chilling.
Thanks for riding up, man.
Of course. I'm glad y'all could have me.
Dude pulls up on a Harley Davidson, so that's pretty cool.
That was
broom, broom.
I got a little jealous. We're good though.
You can hop on the back if you want.
Can you take me for a ride? Go.
I'll take you for a ride.
Uh-oh. Bro,
back to crack. Let's go.
Yo, back to crack. That's what they call it.
We're in Cartersville, not Crackworth.
Yeah. I mean, it flashed on here too. It flashed on here.
It goes, man.
It goes.
It was just a joke.
Anyways.
Chill. Just a freaking joke.
Where are you coming from today?
Kennesaw.
From Kennesaw. Word.
Mm-hmm. Thought you were about to say McDonald's or something. Like,
No, it was my girlfriend's dad's birthday. So I actually came from an upscale Italian restaurant.
Very cool.
Happy birthday,
Happy
Chris.
Birthday, girlfriend's dad.
Happy birthday.
Hell yeah. Cool. What's his name?
Chris.
Happy birthday, Chris.
Happy birthday, Chris.
Turns 41
fellow
today.
Fellow cancer. Woo.
41. Nice. How old are you, Garrett?
I'm 18.
Bro, blowing my mind, man. You just released an album.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You're in college.
True.
Man's got his life together. Man's got some things going on and still does the freaking music thing and still kills it at that. Still plays his shows. Still shows up for school.
Most of the
How
time.
Do you do it, Garrett? What's your secret, man? Because we're we're happy to be doing a podcast, bro.
Yeah, no, I'm glad to be on here, I guess.
Well,
my only secret is I drink a lot of Dr. Pepper. I don't know if there's something in there, but it hasn't done me wrong so far. I'm still waiting on the sponsorship.
Okay. You think it's the 28 Flaves?
Yeah.
I think so.
It's the perfect amount of syrupy and sweet. Just enough to keep you going, but still keep you chilled out.
Oh.
Damn.
Bro,
yeah you should be a spokesman.
Yeah, absolutely, man.
Dude,
you make me
got
thirsty,
me sold, bro.
I know. I'm waiting for the sponsorship to roll in.
He looks at the camera every time.
Dr. Pepper, if you're watching.
Taco Bell for
please,
us.
Yeah, right?
I'll take Taco Bell, too. Or Sam's Cola.
We're going to land
any
you
of the
business
above.
Deal up in here, bro.
Absolutely.
Business.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Well, cool. So tell us about this new album that you just released, which congratulations, by the
way. Thank you very much. Yeah, no, the new record was, it was dope. I've been working on it since 2018.
That's what I thought, man.
Yeah, it's been a long time in the works just because pretty much I recorded half the record and I haven't been doing music full time for super, super long. I've been doing it like full time for about the past 3 years now.
Okay.
So even halfway through the record, like I could feel my voice like sounding different. And not only that, but I was doing a lot more live shows with the band, so the songs were changing. So pretty much went back and re-recorded the first half of the album.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And then writing more songs past then. So all of this has kind of been... And then I sat on the record once it was done for like 8 months, waiting for a good time to release it.
Why did you do that?
Because I just wanted
that
to plan it
sounds uncomfortable,
out.
Bro.
It was a little bit.
For 8 months solid?
It's not a big record, but...
Dang, bro.
No.
Get some scoliosis if you keep sitting on stuff.
Right? No, I was just waiting to try and get some time where I'd have time to play more
why,
dates.
Why'd you sit on it for so long?
I just wanted to...
Just do like a market? Like
yeah, just that, and I could get more dates lined up, but then coronavirus happened.
Sure.
And it didn't go away, so I was like, hell with it. I'm putting it out now.
Yeah.
We're vibing.
Coronavirus.
Now it's out.
That's what coronavirus is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that screwed up everybody's shit, man. And I hate to hear that, but at least it's out now.
Yeah, no, and it's...
You're booking shows again, right?
Yeah, and we did a record release show at this place that's been booking me forever. I've been going to this place since I was literally like 8, and it was really awesome. It was on an outdoor stage. They had a patio, and it was down to standing room only, to the point where people were standing in the parking lot
because
there was not room. Yeah, it was really dope.
That's badass, man.
Mm-hmm. I've been hearing, man. That was down at Buzzy's?
Yeah.
Okay, hell yeah. Dude, I was playing a gig that night, or I would have been there.
I know.
You know, bro, come on. Yeah, I heard that was popped off. Yeah, like, it was people were out there.
A whole lot of fun.
That's awesome. What's up, dude?
Mm-hmm.
That's quite a testimony to, like, the artist, you know, you are and everything, because when you have people actually show up for your stuff, like, that's like, okay, damn, people are actually, like, paying attention. So
I didn't know what to expect for the turnout, especially because it was supposed to rain that night, too, but the rain held off. Mm. It, like, cooled down, and, yeah, just a huge turnout. So that was, I couldn't have asked for anything better.
Universe was like, okay, Garrett, go ahead and put that
on. Mm-hmm. They're like, you get a pass tonight.
It's time. Yeah.
Don't screw up the songs.
You got some good feedback from it so far?
Or? Yeah, no, yeah, a lot of the people who bought it, like, I was just, like, even at the record release, surprised at how many CDs I sold.
Wow.
And, you know, a lot of people, when they've seen me, they've only seen me do solo shows, because that's still the majority of what I do. So people like hearing me with full band stuff. They're like, yes, I think this makes sense.
An element, yeah.
I think you're one of the rare artists that, you know, can do both. So,
yeah, I've always kind of prided myself on being able to be solo, but I don't get out too much. So I still have enough. I feel like I have enough energy
to
carry stuff.
You're young, bro. Come on,
right?
Bro.
That too.
Dude. Yeah. Man, I'm getting old.
Well, dude, I got to commend you on like sitting on it for so long, because I feel like at one point, I mean, did you ever think like, oh, maybe I should just release the ones that I've already got recorded as an EP or something? Or did that ever cross your mind? Or were you like, I'm just going to wait and build one big album and put it on there?
Well, the thing was, I went back. That was kind of, when I first started recording it, it was going to be an EP.
Gotcha.
But then I wrote a lot more songs, and I was like, oh, okay, maybe I should turn this into a record. And then I was going to pare it back and be like, no, I'll just, like, do the best ones, put that out as an EP. But then I wrote some better songs, and I'm like, well, maybe I have enough to carry a record. So, yeah, no, I was pretty proud of most of the songs on there. But, yeah, it's definitely got some of the better ones that I've written so far.
That's
so
great.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I love it. I've been listening to
Thank
it.
You.
I've listened to it a few times. Tell you, I really
dig
it.
Hear it.
Yep. We're gonna play one of his tracks tonight too. One of my favorites on the album.
It sucks.
No, it does not.
Not really.
It's great. Was Highwayman? Is that what we were with?
That was the only cover on the record.
Oh, okay.
Oh, gotcha. Mm-hmm.
Is that a cover?
Yeah.
Why did I know that?
That's an old song.
Oh,
it was originally a Jimmy Webb song. He was like, I think he put it out in like the early 60s.
Wow.
And then The Highwaymen, which was Johnny Cash, Willie Nelson, Kris Kristofferson, and Waylon, they covered it. And that's the one that made it famous.
Maybe
that's... And it's very... early 80s country sounding.
Okay. Gotcha.
But, like, you know, the story in the song, it was actually the White Buffalo. He covers it live, and that was, like, the one that got me, because I'd known the song before, but when I heard it in that setting, which is kind of what I based the record version off of, I was like, this is it.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, that's how I would feel about your version.
Oh, thank you.
You know what I mean? So I'm like, well, that's my favorite of it. I didn't know it was a cover.
Yeah.
But now that it is, it's like, that's my favorite.
I think I can write
cover.
That well.
Well, bro.
I know, I'm kidding.
Mostly. Do you think you can?
It depends. Sometimes I get lucky. A lot of the lucky tracks made it on this
one. Well, who don't, man? I feel like that's half of songwriting.
True.
You know?
Yeah. No, definitely.
Sometimes it takes three hours to, like, write a song. Sometimes it takes as long as the song is, you know? Like,
yeah.
You just put it out there like that, and that's the lucky ones.
It's funny. My favorite two songs on this record, which, you know, a lot of people are like, oh, you can't pick favorite songs. That's like picking a favorite child. No,
nope.
I have favorites. So, but yeah, my favorite ones on this record were ones that really, like, came in pretty much almost all at the same time.
What made you release Lily as a single? I was curious.
You know, the record, it's kind of got those two parts to it. So it's like the more upbeat rock loud side, but it's also got a lot of slower acoustic tracks like that one. And since I put out Birmingham as the single, that was... I felt like it set a pretty good tone for the second half of the record. And I had my good friend Jana Jennings. She did the other vocals on there. We did that one as a duet. So she made it sound real pretty. So
nice.
I was like, I'll do the one where I got help.
I was wondering if you did that. I didn't know if it was your mom. That'd been pretty cool, too.
No, that would have been dope. We tossed that idea around back and forth a bit, but...
Yeah, I know she could sing, too.
Mm-hmm. No, yeah. She's... I got it from there.
Yeah. So. Yeah, that same.
It's not from my dad. He's not allowed to sing in the shower. I love you, Dad.
Hell yeah. What's up, AWOL?
What up, Doc?
You quiet tonight, bro? Dude was like, man, I gotta go get a Red Bull, man.
I'm so sleepy.
We work out in the heat.
Chillin', man. I'm listening.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
I got lucky. I slept in this morning.
Hey, there you go.
Dude, hush. There you go. You make me mad, man.
I love you.
I love you too, bro.
Well, dude, I got a question. Tell us about your time as it's like a Garrett Wheeler fun fact. Tell us about your time as Carl's backup on The Walking Dead.
Yeah.
Not a lot of people know that. Yeah. So
this is taking it back. No. It's funny. I literally had this conversation with like my best friend pretty much right now because I didn't really reconnect with him.
We didn't have that conversation.
No.
Yeah, another best friend. Gotcha. Never mind. Anyways, continue.
No, because we've been like best buds for about the past year now. And he's like, wait, you were on The Walking Dead? Because I mentioned something about it. But yeah, no, I don't, it feels like a life ago just cause, but before I did music, I was actually into acting. I've been doing like,
that's pretty cool,
modeling and stuff. Since, I did modeling starting out when I was 4, you know,
wow.
I believe it or not, I was like a cute little child.
You so man.
It's all the hair. Hey, you know, it's all the hair, but yeah, no. So I did modeling and stuff. And then as I got older, it was more acting and stuff. And it was just another thing where they're like, yeah, we're looking for a teenage boy, like between 5'4" and 5'7", you know, this type build. And I was like, hey, I'm
that's
that
me.
Type build.
Yeah,
yeah, so crazy. Put in for that. This was back in like 7th grade, and I was a fan of the show before sure. I did it. So, because when they put out these casting calls, they don't tell you what it's for until later.
Oh, really?
So
huh?
I did the stuff, yeah. And... then got the thing. I was like, yeah, the show's for The Walking Dead. Or auditions are here. And I was like, yo, this is dope.
You're so like, I made
so
it.
So I literally left a school field trip early to go down to this audition. And where is it?
Where's the field trip?
The field trip was to Stars and Strikes.
Oh, nice.
You know, hey, vibing cool. out in Woodstock.
There you go.
But yeah, no. So I drove down to, it's past Macon, Georgia. The name, Sonoya. I don't know why that was so hard to remember. But yeah, I go to the studio down there. It was like gated off. And, you know, we got there like 2 hours early because we wanted to make sure we were there on time. And it's like a 2-hour drive. And literally as we're chilling in the parking lot, we get out to walk around. My mom wants to have a cigarette. So we walk around a bit. And then this Jeep pulls up in front of the casting studio and out hops Norman Reedus, who plays
nice.
Daryl Dixon on the show.
Yeah.
So, you know.
Yeah, we got him right here, actually.
Yes, this picture was from that day.
Oh, nice.
That moment.
I'm having a hard time here figuring out how to do that. Why can't I?
But, yeah, so.
That's pretty cool.
He saw me kind of just standing there pretty much just like.
He was so like, what's up, man?
He literally just said, hey, what's going on? And I'm like, yeah, I'm here auditioning for Chandler's new photo double. And he's like, yo, that's dope. And he's like, you a fan of the show? I was like, am I a fan of the show? Yes.
That's super dope, bro.
But yeah, then he was like, and he, I was like,
guy.
Yo,
that's the coolest guy on the show, by the way.
He's got the crossbow and everything.
No, I've
yeah.
got an even better story after this one. But
he was the coolest one.
Who was that on the right?
Other than you, he was the coolest guy.
That was me.
That was you?
That was
you?
Baby
no,
Garrett.
It was you?
Yeah.
No, I'm just messing with you.
I was about to say. But yeah, no, so I went through the thing, and yeah, when he saw me, took the picture, and he wound up giving me like a bunch of free merch. Like I still have these sunglasses and a hat he gave me. But yeah, then this was later after I'd been doing it, because that was I started on the season finale of season 4, which was dope. But, yeah, then later when we were filming for season 5, Norman, he rides. He has a show, but he brought his Bonneville to set one day. And he knew my mom rode because both my parents ride motorcycles. And he literally offered – he was like, do you want to ride my bike to my mom?
What? Oh, yeah. Wow.
And she said no because she's bad with clutches and it's Norman Reedus's bike. So she's like, yeah, no, I would have been nervous. But – the woman who plays Carol, she was standing with us too, and she looks at Norman and she's like, "Well, you've never offered to let me ride it before."
Oh, snap.
It was really fun.
Damn.
Oh, man, territorial there. Huh.
Yeah. Like, all in good fun, but
he's like, "Oh, these people are good people."
No, literally every actor on the show was amazing. It was such a great experience. And it was my last big acting thing too, before I kind of made the swap over to music and stuff. But yeah, no, it was
That's
amazing. Dope,
dude. What a story, huh?
Yeah, right?
Yeah, you'll never forget that, man.
Mm-hmm. Well, do you think you'd ever get back into acting? Not to get off
topic. I don't know. It's I'm not sure that I would. Yeah. It was definitely fun, but no.
Fuck it. Go music.
You know what? Yeah, maybe. Maybe. I mean, hey, if they want to remake A Star Is Born again in like 10 years, I mean, hell.
There you
not?
Go, dude. Lady Gaga.
No, yeah, wait, oh, no.
She'll be a little wrinklier by then. But
actually, yeah, I was talking to those guys. They picked Brad over me because of like some technical stuff, but whatever.
Really? Damn.
It was between me and Brad for that, you know, me and Lady.
Totally.
Me and Gaga were hanging that day, and she's like, "Oh, you should be in my movie." Like,
chilling with
you. You know, it's a big fiasco. Whatever.
Mm-hmm.
It's all good.
We'll Woody should have
Thanks,
been.
Brad.
Yeah, Brad. Bradley.
Coop. I just called him
Thanks,
Coop.
Coop.
I called him Coop after that. I was like, "Yeah, what's up, Coop?"
Yeah.
And he was like, "Boo, don't call me that." I'm like, "You're being a little
don't
bitch.
Call me Coop."
No, I'm just kidding, man.
Totally.
Now you're doing the music thing. You're rocking with that. I think you should stick with your guns, man.
Yeah, it feels a lot better
but
when
you
act.
You can also be like an actor and musician, Justin Timberlake.
Shoot that.
Yeah,
shoot
for
that.
Real.
Well, he also danced, too. You could probably pick up like charisma, like doing like choreographed.
No,
like,
I'm the most uncoordinated person.
Bro.
Dude, I don't have two left feet. I just have like imaginary nubs. I cannot move. Like, I can play music. I can play in time pretty well, but I got no rhythm. I can do the Cotton Eye Joe. That's about it.
Hey, I want to see you play guitar, dance, and sing.
And act.
I can barely play guitar and sing at the same time.
Bro.
That was the biggest thing. I played guitar for like 2 years before that clicked. Like, I just could not for the longest time, no matter how hard I practiced.
That is one of those like
whatever.
Big bridges to kind of hurdle over,
like,
for sure.
It was insane. But the funny part was, I suck at guitar now, but I used to be pretty good at guitar. But then when I started singing with it too, I literally had to relearn.
I don't know. I think that's making you a better guitar player. Relearning.
Yeah.
Learning,
no. Learning, definitely.
And like progressing.
I'm definitely a way better rhythm player.
Card in your deck, man.
Yeah. Like, well, that's one thing I will pride myself on. I'm a great rhythm player.
For sure.
For as shit rhythm
as
I have.
That's what I was about to say.
I'm a great rhythm player.
Like,
as far as lead goes, not quite. But I can fake it.
That's another card, man. Work on it. It's like a video game. Like, earn your points, get that card, and like put it in your deck. Right.
Get like 10 health. And
then you're like. A weapon, guitar weapon,
lethal weapon.
It's kind of like a Guitar Hero when you'd build up the stars and build up the guitar.
You gotta shake the guitar.
I suck at Guitar Hero.
I only played that once in Walmart.
Damn,
that's my funny thing. My girlfriend and her roommate. That's pretty much what they do. About 80% of the time is they just sit and play Rock Band, and I suck at all the instruments. I can't play drums. I can't do the Rock Band guitar.
Yeah, ain't that
so funny? They're like, "Yeah, just do vocals. That's what you do." And I failed out on the song on vocals. I was like, "Oh, wow, that's funny."
They don't know shit, dude.
Yeah, I remember the song. It was We Got the Beat, but I was doing it like up the octave. So I'm just like, "We got the beat, we got..." Like a fucking alien filter.
Oh.
So it was goofy. It was really goofy.
Wasn't that song on Jimmy Neutron?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah, I also had Aaron Carter. Party in the USA. What is it?
Miley Cyrus. Died.
They had an Aaron Carter song. I remember. I Want Candy. Maybe.
No, that's Pink.
I Want Candy. That's Aaron Carter.
No, that
bro.
Is Aaron Carter.
all that era of pop was very similar.
It all blends together.
Yeah, bro. That was
about the last time I liked pop music. Though,
you were so young and then, bro. We're
those are my
old,
skating
dog,
rink
right?
days.
I had those days.
I used to live at the skating rink before I had my throat surgery.
Oh, like, bro, that was the spot, right?
I literally lived up there like 4 or 5 days a week. I'd stay there for like 6 hours after school.
That was
a
spot. After school.
I got out of school to close. It was fun.
Was it like cover gigs or what? Like cover gigs or...
It was a skating gig. He had to skate around and play and sing.
Oh, bro, you can skate and play?
He had a little lavalier mic and everything.
I don't know. I haven't tried yet, but I want to now that we're talking about
it. Don't try it, man. You fall. That hurt.
I just got to fall on my backside.
So what's next? When you go on tour?
Whenever these venues open back up, I guess. I'd love to.
I feel that.
Yeah. No, whenever I can get stuff lined up. I'm really excited.
Right now, as like as a professional artist and everything, do you have a management or like?
No, everything I've done has all just been me.
No representation or anything like that.
So, no, I mean, my mom's helped out before, just because she used to do it with my acting and stuff, so she knows kind of how to play like that manager role. But as far as like, yeah, most of it's just been me and
working with you.
Yeah.
Do you ever feel like sometimes it could be really helpful to like have somebody that could reach out and like? Do you ever feel like management is the next step, or what do you feel like is the next step for you?
I don't know. I've went back and forth on it a lot, but a lot of like the stories I hear about people getting managers, especially
it's
like
nightmares.
At our level. Yeah. I've never heard any good things. Yeah. And like, you know,
bad people out there.
Yeah. And there's a lot of those, and not even so much bad people, just people who can't deliver on what they say.
Oh, sure.
But Breach. Like, you know, bands like American Aquarium, like I remember they were talking, they didn't have management, and even now, like their front guy, BJ, he still does most of their booking, but just
he
him.
Probably is a manager of some sort. Yes. You know what I mean? There's there's people with that brain, bro.
But that's one thing. I'd rather be my own manager, just because it's like even my thing. I don't like other people packing up my stuff.
Not feel that. Stuff. Yeah, I don't either.
It's weird. I'm a control freak when it comes to music. Anything else, I'm just like, oh yeah, go vibe.
Bro, when it comes to gigs, like, and stuff, I'm the sloppiest. I'm disrespectfully sloppy, like on how sloppy I am with my music. Yeah. But I can't take it too serious, because then I have no fun with it. I can't. Right. Then I'm like, I'm turning it into a job, and I work a job.
Yeah.
And so then it
you don't need
becomes
two of those.
A job, and I'm like, I don't want to do that. As
exactly.
A job. Yeah. And this is my fun time. This is Woody's fun time when I'm up there. Like. And you just so happen to like it too and pay me to come play at your house and stuff.
Yeah.
I ain't going to write it down. I ain't going to email you twice a day, you know, stuff like that. Like,
I'm not going to make these three Instagram posts
for me,
that you require.
I think my step would be like a manager to freaking do that.
No, that makes sense for you.
So it's like a whole different mindset. It's like where you're at as an artist.
Like
so,
with me.
That's awesome that you do your own stuff. So, I would say run with it as far as you can.
That's my thing.
Yeah.
Like even as far as like labels and stuff.
Yeah, dude.
Go.
But that's just a credit card.
Yeah. True.
True that.
Yeah. You're all right.
That's a funny way to look at it.
It is. That's all it is. It's just a bunch of debt, and then you got to pay them back. And then maybe if your album fucking really rocks it,
then you're vibing.
If they like it at the first place, and if they're happy with the album after they make all the changes to your album, and if it sells like that, then it's all theirs.
Yeah.
But you got the money up front, but you owe them.
Mm-hmm.
It's sketchy, bro.
It is sketchy.
Whoever came up with that business plan is
a shot. It's like there are better ways to do it. Like, even with, like, you know, smaller records, like Bloodshot Records. I know there's a bunch of drama going on over there now. But, like, you know, artists like Corey Brannon, he's, like, talked. And he's really cool. I like him. Because even on his records, they just get weird in the best kinds of ways. Mm. Like, you listen through it and it's like, this just sounds like a collection of songs and not a record. Which, like, even he talks about. But he's like, yeah, no, the label doesn't tell me what to do. They let me do what I want.
So, really?
It's about us.
Yeah. But the thing is, those are few and far between.
Yeah.
So, sure.
Absolutely.
It all depends on what's available to you, I guess.
Yeah. You're like one distorted guitar away from being like signed with Third Man Records.
Yeah. No, that's one
that's
thing.
What I could see.
Joshua Headley, he's an artist they signed. He's a Nashville like bar cover guy.
I've heard of him.
Huh?
I've heard of him.
He's so dope, dude. His voice. And it's all like by the book, traditional, like golden era. Huh. Country.
Gotcha. Yeah.
Like, it's crazy. And the second I found out he was signed to Third Man, I was like, this is dope.
Bro, Jack ain't no dummy. He knows good music.
Mm-hmm.
He's
a
weirdo, bro.
Mm-hmm. I don't vibe with his music so much.
Really?
Like, I like it, but, you know, it's just not stuff I usually listen to, I guess. But even with the stuff the people he signs and the stuff he puts on his record, he's got good taste.
Yeah. Mm.
And, like, his influences, too.
It's very stylistic with his music.
I got a question for you.
What's going on?
White Stripes Jack White or solo Jack White?
Solo.
Yes.
Actually, it would go solo, Wrecking Tears, and then...
Really?
Totally forgot about that.
Damn, I love the White Stripes, man. That was something I grew up in middle school.
See, it was my era. Sure. I was a Black Keys kid.
Really? Okay, yeah. You were right after me. Yep.
That'd been so much fun to be like in the Black Keys. Like,
oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I was not any kind of kid.
You're a little shithead.
I'm almost 30.
I'm a little shithead. What is the oldest kid here?
I'm the youngest, dude. Whatever.
Mm-hmm. Plot twist, I'm older than Woody. That's Woody is actually 16 together. Years old.
I'm actually...
almost 30.
Actually, legally, I don't think I proclaim my age.
Can I? Hide that beer.
I'm a bit, yeah. I'm a bit under 20.
Oh, no.
So, yeah. Y'all want to go do a music review time?
Let's do it. I'm down.
It's over there.
All right. Let's go.
We're going to music Come review here, music time. Review.
Woo. Woo!
We got a sick line out, man. This line is sick. We got good people out in this one.
This one's like going to be good.
This is our first episode on YouTube, so YouTube be freaking nice, man. We uncomfortable on this shit. It's a big pond. Facebook kicked us off because of policies, and
they heard that I was coming on, and they said that was unacceptable.
Well, it came down to an insurance thing because people were like flocking in their computers and like hitting their heads on the computers because they were like super excited to see you. So they had to like refund a bunch of phones and computers and stuff.
The servers went down because so many people were just like
breaking the internet in their faces, exactly. Trying to get closer to Garrett.
So I have that effect on people.
In that notes, we had to go to YouTube.
Thank you, YouTube, for giving us a platform to be creative and way better than Facebook in that manner.
I love the sound effects, dude. I feel like the sound effects just take me there, man. All right, so our first artist tonight she's awesome. They're awesome. They're all freaking really talented, and they rock it around Atlanta. This is Reptile Room.
Ooh.
Give me some
Reptile.
And then this song is called Sunlight.
Nice.
Yeah. Feels nice. We're going to listen to Sunlight. You ready? You're going to listen to music?
Let's do it. Let's I got do my it. Music ears on.
Well, this is an artist. Give them a chance to shine. Anybody that writes and records their own music or has somebody else record it and somebody else write it, I don't care. But as long as it's original music, send it in. We play it because we just want to give somebody a platform and
we'll talk about it.
We like to listen to people's music. So we're just like finding new music and good people. So send it in and we will listen to it. CaliforniaDadClub@gmail.com, and this is Reptile Room Sunlight.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
I can see it like a distant storm. Looks so dark, but it feels so warm. I can see it dancing through my door. She wanted to be so much more. I can make it read like a red letter day. In your favorite place, I can believe it's better this way. I can believe whatever you say. Ooh, even though it looks like, even though it looks like rain, it feels like sunlight.
Thank you.
fucking dope, dude. That was sad. Awesome.
Hell yeah, Reptile Room with awesome. Sunlight. Yeah, man. They're freaking dope, bro.
They're badass. So much movement in the song. You know what I mean? I don't know.
Production quality is
absolutely
true to roof.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want to know who produced that. That's
they epic. Did.
That's epic.
I think it might be her brother.
Still, that's dope.
Yeah. They've got really like cool. a little family thing going on, and they stay like in their little circle, and they freaking kill it.
That's awesome.
That's dope.
I really love the beat on that, though.
Yeah.
That beat was sick.
That was quality. It just sounded good. They were at a... The Rock and Taco thing,
yeah,
with Gig Pump, Steve Chelsky and everything.
Yeah, with their band, yeah. Now I wonder, like, when it comes to like Reptile Room stuff, like where, like, how do you perform that though? You know what I mean? Like, do you just like literally have like a computer up on stage and like just and then Sammy's just singing to it?
Probably have one guy on like a beat machine or something.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody on some maybe keys,
some keys or something,
or something.
Yeah,
or some triggers or something. I don't know. Yeah. We'll have to go check it out.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Have to go watch one of our shows.
Yeah, it's sparking some curiosity, so I'd love to go.
Yeah.
See what it's all about.
That's what it is. It's curiosity, so we're going to go check it out. What do you think, Garrett?
No, I love it.
It's dope.
Like, a lot of people don't guess just because of like the genre music I do.
Yeah.
But I listen to a lot of this type of stuff.
Yeah.
And I really vibe with it. This is the first time I ever heard of them, too, or heard anything of theirs. Yeah.
Everybody asks. So,
yeah, no, I really enjoy it. Now I want to hear more.
You got to go see her live. She sings backup with Mother's Finest.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah, and she does some touring with them and whatnot. But she's
and then Alchemy,
voice,
is that the name of the other band? Alchemy, yeah. They play around a good bit.
That's dope.
Stuff.
I'm going to check all of this out.
Yeah. Hell yeah. We'll make it a list. We got a playlist going on, too. California Dad Club playlist on Spotify. So
that's epic.
It's just called CDC. And all the songs that we play on this show are on that playlist. So
go listen to that shit.
Go check it out. Follow that playlist. Got some dope artists lined up. Who do we got next? Ooh. Next we got Athane by Pastel Dynasty, man. These guys singing this song. I dig it. So I listened like the first 5 seconds, so we're just gonna roll with it.
Let's do it.
I like
so we know
it so
the first
far.
5 seconds.
I like it so far.
Let's find out about the rest.
I'm not gonna give
after
it
five
away.
Seconds, just
yeah, if it sucks after five,
it just turns off.
If it sucks after 5 minutes, it's gonna end the stream. I'm just gonna be going. So this is Athane. I think I'm saying that right. Hey, Garrett, you went to school.
Who's that mouse?
Yeah, okay. What is that?
Yeah,
say?
That looks like
a theme.
It looks all right. I don't know.
Hey, I'm not.
I was just really good at history.
I'm smart.
Mom, if you're watching, my mom was an English teacher.
She's proud, bro.
No, what's
if we're saying it wrong, just yell at us through the phone.
A theme.
She can, actually call in. We do have a phone line that she can call
be
in.
Funny.
So.
I see. Show.
Another banger. Pastel Dynasty, man.
That's dope.
That was sick. I really dug that. I like that vibe a lot.
Absolutely.
That's the kind of stuff I would like listen to in the car.
Yeah.
Going down the road.
I love how like punk and hip hop have kind of fused a lot within the past like 5-6 years. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
They done had a little
punk. A little punk, baby. Yeah,
punk pop. Punk, mm-hmm. punk, pump pop.
Hip punk. Hip punk. Punk.
Cop.
Hip punk.
Pimp
hip
block. Punk. Baby.
No, that was super cool, man. It's like, I don't know, you still got your... I mean, that was obviously a punk influence, but with the drums and everything, I definitely heard some hip-hop under roots.
Really? There.
Yeah, for sure. For sure, got a little Pete vibe in there, absolutely.
It's like Lil Peep mixed with Belmont.
What'd you say?
It's like Lil Peep mixed with Belmont.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can hear that.
Yeah. As far as the guitars and the drums and everything, as far as the vocal pattern, that was the more punk
side. I can hear Belmont. Yeah. I never heard anything from Lil
really?
Lil Peepy.
He
needs to make a bigger peep.
Lil Peepy.
He's dead now, so he's not making any peeps anytime soon.
Rest in peace.
Rest in peep.
Damn, bro, we're dark.
No, I dug that. I like the vocals. Remind me of Blink a bit.
Yeah.
Blink. See, I got like an emo-ish vibe from it.
Yeah, no, it definitely had that definitely. Sad boy vibe for sure.
And that's what that is.
Yeah, yeah.
What Peep was.
Yep.
Really?
For sure. Well, that with like hip hop.
I ain't trying to make fun of him or anything. I was just making jokes.
Yeah, though. Dude, you're offending me so freaking hard right now, man.
I'm sorry. God, bro.
I love this Lil Peep. Safe space. I love him.
I'm sorry, bro.
Peep. I'm gonna silence for Lil Peep.
Beep.
Fuck, dude.
Shit. Dude, you fucked it up.
Oh, man. We're going to hop in our next artist. These guys are Jive.
Mm-hmm. Jive Target.
Jive Revival. And this song is called Big Black Leather.
Oh, God. I did not know where you were going with this.
Jive Revival. I like that, man.
Mm-hmm. No, I've always kind of wished I could like belt like that.
Me too, man. They have that grit. I want that grittiness.
When I belt, it just sounds like I'm screaming, which that has its own vibe.
Give us a little sample.
Y'all got to pay extra for that.
You take debit?
I only take payment in Arby's.
I'm supporting this whole cash thing.
No,
dude, what's the coincidence that they're trying to take away the cash right now in the economy and everything? You know, it's trying to make it a
very, very weird, isn't it?
Electronic, all like.
Oh yeah, I know a lot of places, you know what I mean? They're not taking change.
Yeah, they won't.
Like they'll take cash money, but like not coins. Which doesn't make sense.
I don't know how up to date you are and whatever. Mm-hmm. But the first time that I ever like heard you or saw you or heard of you, you were so into Johnny Cash.
I know.
What's the coincidence?
No, when I started up, I was pretty much a Johnny Cash tribute artist.
Nice.
And I've spent the past 2 years trying to get away from that.
I still
love Johnny Cash.
I meant to ask you that. That was one of my questions I was going to ask you. Is like, how is that? Like, because that's where I saw you at. Mm-hmm. You know, is like the beginning. Very, yeah. Very, very beginning.
Well, I mean, back then my voice was lower too.
I think that was before you had like songs that you were singing of your own, like out and stuff.
So yeah, I had one original out.
Dude, you've come such a long way.
Thank you.
I just want to congratulate you on that.
Thank you very much.
Dude. You've like such grown as a
I started man. Really, really low, so that still don't say much, but no, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Thank you.
Yeah, dude, you've come a long way. I remember that, and I was like, wow, I forgot that that's where you started from, because that was such a change to where you are now, I know.
So. Yeah, that was it.
Kicking ass now.
Louis Huey's, wasn't it?
Yeah.
The Louis Huey's.
The open mic thing.
Yeah. And now I'm not allowed up there.
Really?
Strict on their rules. Yeah, I'm too young.
You're too young?
Yeah, because it's 21 and over up there.
Do they not like money?
Huh?
Do they not like money?
I know. It's dumb. Like, that's the thing. I played shows there for a long time, and then out of nowhere, they're just like, yeah, we can't book you anymore because you're a child. Sorry.
Yeah, they're ridiculous.
Take your tacos.
But then...
Shove them up your ass.
Who is it?
AWOL wasn't going to say it. I'll say it.
It was like, I did not play there for like 8 or 9 months. And then out of the blue, it was the old manager there. She hits me up and she's like, hey, are you free to play this weekend? I was like, y'all are going to book me? She's like, yeah, no, I'd love to. We haven't had you here in forever. So I don't know if that was just like a different manager who was being a hard ass or something.
They switched like a bunch of management.
Yeah.
Whatever.
I can't play there. I got banned because I took my freaking shirt off at a gig, and I didn't know that you were allowed to do that.
We all took our shirts off at the one open mic con.
Yeah, but apparently someone posted a picture of me with the shirt off on the internet, and the owner didn't take too kindly to that.
No shirt, no service.
Did you used to work there, bro?
And I was working there, too. Yeah, so.
No, that was the crazy thing when you used to run the open mic there, because you were running the open mic, but... also working at the same time.
Yeah. No, that lasted like 2 weeks. And then after that, I was like, nope, I'm just going to do this. So
I did the
open mic thing, which dude was a blast, but until I got in trouble for taking off my shirt. And
Ricky Cole did it and stood on the bar and cracked the bar.
Yeah. And he's not banned.
No.
Yeah. No, they have a personal event. No, he did for like, he got a little slap on the wrist, but he gets to play there. Yeah, it's a personal vendetta against AWOL. Poor little AWOL, dude.
I love Ricky, dude.
I love Ricky, dude.
Maybe that's why they don't let me up, because they just see me and all they can think of is you.
They're like, bro,
if
you take your shirt off, too.
No, people have walked up and been like, Austin, wait. And I'm like, yeah, it's not me.
I'm just his better looking younger brother. So you got to say.
I
get the Trevor Lawrence thing a lot.
Yeah, I was about to say, y'all both look like y'all could be related to Trevor Lawrence.
See, the thing I always get is Jay Adams, the old skater.
Oh, yeah.
I just want to see y'all hang out with Trevor Lawrence all day. And just like,
dude, we should make that happen. Trevor, if you're watching this,
wear all the same shit and just like walk around in all the same place and just be like three like ostrich.
Just throwing the football around all day.
Amazing. Trevor Lawrence is walking around, dude, just like, what?
Just get one big ass Clemson jersey that we all like wear. We're all just like,
Trevor.
Trevor Lawrence,
hey,
dude.
Hey, Trevor, look at us. You see this gap in the middle?
Come on, Trevor.
This could be you.
This could be us.
This could be it.
This could be us, but you're playing.
It'd be the funniest shit. Sorry. I'm a little running with my imagination right now. I'm three beers deep.
But big black leather. That was dope.
I wanted to give a shout out to... Well, I got announced today. My first time ever getting announced that I'm official member of a band.
Nice.
Ooh. Okay, I'm going to give myself a little bit of a... Oh, a little negative vibe. A little bit of... Yeah. I joined a band. Nah, I'm just kidding. These bands. They're awesome.
What band?
It's called the County Line Kings, man.
What kind of kind of music?
Well, we're doing, it's like covers.
Yeah.
Mostly. But we the thing is they're all freaking killers. And so we're going to like rock a house like and Hell make yeah. it one of the best like cover nights they've ever heard, cuz we've got like all the vibes. Like we're going everywhere from like Foo Fighters to Queens of Stone Age, and
that's dope.
Fucking yeah, we're going all over the board. Like,
can I be your tambourine player, little cabo?
Don't be a tambo, bro.
Little
skin flute player.
This is our tambo, bro.
Tambo, bro.
No, I'll just be y'all's go-go dancer.
There you go.
Well, we're talking a couple years when you hit that like
20 mark
of the, you know, the mark of the beast, 21. I'm just kidding. No, I'm excited anyways. I told him I'd shout him out on the podcast tonight.
Word. That's awesome.
Yeah, anyways.
Shout out, County Line Kings.
I'm a catcher show. Y'all should too.
Yeah.
Fucking love it. No, we're about to release our first, I can't announce it right now, but we're about to debut our first show.
Music video. Up,
so. And when that does happen, we haven't played one show and we already got 1,200 likes on Facebook.
That's epic. Damn,
shit's already like lit. So, and we ain't done nothing. So our first show is coming up on probably next month, I think. So,
nice, dude.
All right. Yeah. Thank you, Jive Revival. Sorry that wasn't much about your music, man, because that was a great ass song.
That was great.
I love all the organ stuff on it too, and the stops.
The guitars,
in there,
bro.
The stops were dope. I vibe with stops like that.
Yeah. Just tightness in the pocket.
I can't play that well.
Me neither. I'm way too sloppy for that shit. The guitar was on point, though. Like, some guitar runs out there I heard caught me off guard. All about it. They know they're good. That's the fact. All right, and the next one we got. Who's the next one? Oh, no.
It's our very own.
Mr. Garrett. Oh, crap, hold on.
Fuck yeah!
I love this guy!
We getting hyped up for this?
Yeah!
We're talking about doing jumping jacks to stay awake. Is it hype jumping jacks time?
Pretty much. Pretty much.
Drop down and give me 20!
Who the hell is this guy?
This guy is Garrett Wheeler.
Who the hell is Garrett Wheeler?
He's my buddy, and we've enjoyed having him on the podcast tonight, man. For real.
It's been a blast.
Non-COVID handshakes. Because we're clean up in this motherfucker.
Yeah.
We cuss too. Sorry, your fans do cool cussing. You seem a little bit rock and roll, bro. So I
don't know. I mean,
a little bit of kissing cuss word, bro.
No. I got to keep my mouth as, you know, I'm not allowed to cuss. Like, what the hell is that? I mean, like, I just get shit on endlessly if I cussed. God. Like, I mean, that'd be fucking awful.
Bro, you've got a shirt.
It's all jokes.
You've got a whole shirt with hell on it.
Exactly. I always joke when I turn 21, I'm going to change it to that one word that rhymes with truck.
He cusses.
I got my grandma.
Freedom.
My grandma watches all my stuff. So
Fritos.
I keep it safe for grandma.
Yeah.
Funnel.
Because if she doesn't get any spanking, one of us will.
Right. But if you come out to a live show,
and on that
don't
note.
Come out if you have sensitive ears. I say bastard in this song. I think that's about it.
Bastard? That ain't bad.
No.
Bastard's like...
Bastard's
I don't
fun.
Think that's
dogs.
Like, yeah. That's
not even a cuss word.
Hmm?
Bastard? That's not even a cuss
A bastard
word.
Is like an actual thing. Yeah, that's
yeah,
like
bastard.
A...
Bastard.
Yeah, that's like a... Where yeah,
he's a
it's like
bastard,
bitch.
Dude.
Like, it's
yeah.
Technically... Bitch?
Yeah.
It's the... Well, it's the... A bastard is a...
It's someone without a father.
Yeah. It's someone whose dad cheated on their mom with someone else, and that the other woman's kid is the bastard.
I thought that was a cheater.
Or you can just
no,
call
the cheater's the dad.
Bastard.
Oh, the kid is the bastard.
Where's the bastard at, though? Where does he live?
The bastard, wherever the father decides to raise him, I guess.
Yeah, it's a crazy situation, bro. Anyway.
Watched a lot of Game of Thrones, man. I don't know.
Golly, bro. You got confused.
You all did his research on this one.
You thought you were watching something? You got confused, bro. You weren't watching shit. He was watching you. All right, next up, we got Highwayman by Mr. Garrett Wheeler. And I can't believe this cover. You want to play another one since it's cover?
You can play whatever you want.
I love this one. I love all yours, so I'm good with anything. But
go for it.
All right, let's go. We're going to do Highwayman.
Yeah.
It's working.
I was a highwayman. On the coach roads I did ride, with a sword and pistol by my side. Many young maid lost their baubles to my trade. Many a soldier shed their lifeblood on my blade. Bastards hung me in the spring of 25. I'm still alive. I was a sailor. I was born upon the tide. Here with the sea I did abide. Sailed a schooner around the Horn of Mexico. I went aloft to furl the mainsail in a blow. When the odds broke off, they said that I got killed. I am living still. I was a dam builder. Crossed this river deep and wide. Where steel and water did collide. Place called Boulder on the wild Colorado. I slipped and fell into the wet concrete below. They buried me in that great tomb that knows no sound. I am still around. And I'll always be around and around and around and around and around and around.
Hey!
Flew a starship across the universe divide. And when I reach the other side, I'll find a place to rest my spirit if I can. Perhaps I may become a highwayman again. I may simply be a single drop of rain. I will remain. I'll be back again and again and again. And again and again and again. And again and again and again. And again, 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 and again.
Sucked.
I hate that singer.
No, that was dope, dude. That was dope.
You're your worst critic, man.
You are so right.
Dude, that's just part of being an artist, though. Yeah. Like, if I, dude, if I was to, like, sit and, like, yeah, I would be the same way. I'd be like, oh, I could have done that way differently. Like, oh, fuck.
No, half of it's just jokes. The other half is deep down insecurities.
Yeah, I know, bro.
They keep me up at night.
I know, bro. It's okay.
But mostly, it's all for the meme, bro.
Bro, you just got to realize that you're in the music. You can't see it.
Exactly.
You're in it.
No, I mean, even if I don't love myself, maybe I'm just not my own type.
Somebody else will, though. Bro.
Exactly. I'm just trying to play songs.
But you do have to love yourself, bro. There's a lot. I feel like there is a fine line between being confident and being arrogant.
No, definitely.
You know, so.
That's a biggie. I pride myself on being a very confident person,
mm-hmm.
but also being humble.
Yeah, dude, you got the swagger. You know what? You know what? You do. You know what you carry, bro. And I feel like you are. You are a good balance. Like
I try to be.
You are, but as when it comes to like people listening to music, bro, you got to be like, fuck.
Oh,
really
I
album.
But when people ask,
but then like, when you go home, be sucks, like, oh, dude. Damn it, they
not really. Then you get I'm actually really proud of it, but. That's the thing. I just love saying like both back to back because I'll be like, yeah, no, I'm super proud of it. It sucks so bad. But I mean, this is, it's just funny watching the reaction.
So excited to be here, but yeah, fuck yeah, that sucked. But yeah, hell yeah. That was awesome. So I just had a, sorry, that made no sense, but I was like thinking of something else.
Where's a sad trombone when you need one?
Hold on. I got it right here. It's still black and white, bro. My ball is slipping. I'm getting tired. There it is. Should we call JK and Michael? Michael?
Let's call him.
Michael?
Michael.
Should we call him?
Yeah, let's do it.
Jake Aaron Michael.
Jake Aaron Michael.
Let's call Jake Aaron Michael.
He was just calling me.
Yeah, let's call him.
Let's talk to Jake Aaron Michael.
We have lucky caller number 3 on the show. That's a good question.
Be like, yo, Jake, call us back, fool.
He's not answering.
We love you, bro. Kiss, kiss.
Well, he was trying to call me. I was like, well, forget. He's one of our future guests coming on here, too.
Yeah, it was worth the call to him.
Yeah.
Try.
We always try to give a call sometimes. All right, man. We love you guys. Thank y'all for tuning in and watching us. Follow us, subscribe. Hey,
thank you, YouTube.
We gotta do the typical.
Oh yeah, go like and subscribe.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's your boy Woody. This is AWOL right here.
Ow.
We got our boy Garrett right here.
What's going on, everybody?
Yo, what's up, man? Make sure to like and subscribe and hit that smash that subscribe button. And follow us for future videos.
Be sure you turn on your notifications so you're notified every time I post a video or go live.
Yeah. That's right.
Also, subscribe to my
Hit
Patreon.
Hit that little bell. And also my sign Patreon, up for my email list.
My OnlyFans.
And follow me on Twitter and Instagram, CaliforniaDadClub@gmail.com. Email me. You can text me, too.
Also, you know what makes me get California Dad Club going
What's
the most?
That, AWOL?
Is Squarespace. You can actually go in and type the code Cali Dad Club and get a free code for a free month of Squarespace.
Get your free one.
We are also sponsored by Dollar Shave Club, who have sent us these awesome
these big old nanas.
We're
these
actually
big old
not
nana themed razors. No, we're not. But if anyone wants to sponsor Cali Dad Club,
yeah, we're broke, man. Anyways, yep. We love you guys, and one more thing, guys.
Be careful out there in the universe, man.
Be careful.
Just remember, breathe. Be Everything's good. Okay.
Be good.
It's gonna be okay.
Thanks, Garrett.
Thanks, Woody. I didn't know we were doing ASMR now.
We are. With reverb.
Hi.
God damn it.